What's up, everybody? Chris M. Walker from Legiit and Superstar SEO here. Today, I've got a kind of a different video for you, at least for my channel. I'm going to show you a ChatGPT prompt that I used to do over 100 and somewhere, I made up the number if I'm being perfectly honest, but around 124 local SEO audits in about a day. So it's pretty straightforward. I'm going to show you the results of a few of them. Then I'm going to run a couple for you so you can see it happen. And then I'm going to give you the prompt that you can use yourself. And that's pretty much all there is to it. Let's jump over into my computer and check it out. All right, so you can see 2 days ago, and right now it is May 31st, 2023. Happy summer, everyone, at least in the United States. you can see that I said, this used to be in the big purple text, but I added some text and it got smaller, but it says, give me the name of a business and the city it is in, and I will give you a free local SEO plan. And as you can see, it got quite a lot of interest to the point where it took me an extra day to do all of it because I couldn't keep up because I got quite a few in DM as well. And then I asked over here in the Superstar SEO Facebook group and same deal, got tons of interest and gave out a lot of audits. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm going to show you a sample of a couple of them, and then we're gonna do a couple in real time, and then I'm gonna give you the prompt so you can use it yourself to do audits for your own clients and businesses, or you can even sell this as a service on the greatest business platform in history of history, Legiit.com. So let's check it out. All right, so I picked three of the ones I did at random. And this is the output. It's, it uses the same sentence at the beginning. And then every time it's a little bit different, which I guess makes sense because, well, no, it's a computer. It's still a computer, even though it's sophisticated. But as you can see, it gives usually around 5 points and then this table with different descriptions and things like that. Sometimes it gives you keywords. I specifically ask it to give keywords. So it does that. And so here's another one. I guess it's a little bit different every time. I'm not sure why. I guess because, like I said, it's a computer and, you know, it's not 100% yet. And sometimes it doesn't do the table like that, but it gives, I think this is pretty in-depth information. I have certainly paid more. I've certainly paid money for less than this and certainly been sent things unsolicited that were less involved in this. And it only takes a minute or two to produce. So let's go over, well, let's do this first. Let's do Myrtle Beach Roofer, and let's just pick one at random. Scroll down a bit so it's somebody that needs it. Let's go, Linta Roofing is gonna be our winner. So let's open up ChatGPT. Hopefully everybody knows what ChatGPT is. If not, I'm sorry. And I'm going to copy my prompt. Change out that. We're going to put in the business name. And I'm going to walk you through the prompt at the end. Myrtle Beach SC. And by the way, I played with this, and you could put just the city, you can put the city, state, and country, you can put city, state, you can spell out the state. It didn't seem to make much difference. So let's go ahead and chat this away, or I don't know what you really call it when you do this. Let's search, whatever. And of course you could change this to however many keywords you want. Sometimes it'll tell you to continue generating, and if it does, you just click continue generating. And there you go. Now, if you were gonna hand this over to someone, you might wanna go through and make sure that the facts are right, or that the grammar is right and things like that, but that's pretty much it. So like I said, sometimes it will generate the nice looking table like this, sometimes it doesn't. I haven't quite figured out why that is. I assume it's just because, you know, it's still a computer and it does what it does, but I'll walk through what each of these is when we get done. Let's go do another one. Another one. Let's go with Milwaukee Let's go with chiropractor. And we'll just go with let's go with this one. McCann Chiropractic. Okay, let's go with McCann Chiropractic. I think I spelled that right. No. In Milwaukee. I don't know why I always choose Milwaukee. So let's take a look at that. And see, this time it is doing the nicely formatted table. I don't know why sometimes it does and sometimes it doesn't. Continue generating. And there you go. And like I say, you want to go through and make sure that this makes sense for the business and there's no grammar errors and things like that in here. But this is a pretty well formatted audit with some decent information in it that you can get done in just a couple seconds for just pasting in a prompt, you know what I mean? And it's pretty good. You know, it certainly can save you a ton of time. And if you're just looking to use this as a foot in the door type of thing to get a new client, which is what I suggest you do, I think it's great. You save this and then you just go in and you find somebody that needs SEO and you generate this for them and you send it to them and say, look, here's some free information for you. If you're interested in getting these things fixed, let me know and I can help you. If not, here they are and you can do whatever you like with them. Here's my contact info, something like that. And you'll be good, right? So let's do one more. Let's change cities again to Detroit, kind of in a Midwest mood today. And let's go with HVAC repair. And I'm just searching these because you don't have to search these yourself. I know people get confused when I don't explain every tiny little thing to them. I'm just doing this because I don't know of any businesses and I need to think of some. So let's do JL Heating and Air Conditioning in Detroit. So let's start a new chat. And let's go Detroit. God, I can't type today. Michigan, USA. And let's chat. Keep saying wanting to say search. I don't know why the formatting is different sometimes. Continue generating. This one's formatted quite nicely though. And there you go. So what I would do now is just come over here and go to JLH Heating and Air Conditioning, contact them or call them and say, you just email them and say, hey, JLH Heating, I took the liberty of doing a quick local SEO audit for you, and it's got a bunch of great information that I think can really help your business. Here it is in a Google Doc. It's yours completely free. If you need help implementing any of that, or if you have any questions about it, let me know. Here's my contact information. But either way, I just wanted you to have this information so you can implement it and get some better results, because it looks like you got a great business here, and I just want people to be able to find it as good as possible. So it's yours to keep. Implement it if you want. If you want some help with that, here's how you get a hold of me. Have a great day. Something like that. And, you know, maybe it works, maybe it doesn't, but it's, I think it's a great way to get people to like you, give them some value, and something that doesn't take you a long time to do. I had my assistant did out 40 of these for me in a day while I was doing other things, and then we did the rest of them together. So if you have someone just doing that and sending out emails, you can really make some progress quickly. So, or what you could do is come over here and start a service on Legiit and say, I'm going to, well, not say I'm going to, because God, I hate when people try to start their service with that, but say, come over to local SEO service and list, do a local SEO audit for your business in 24 hours that will give you, you know, X, Y, and Z things, and that you can give to your clients and just charge, you know, $6 or $10 or $20 or whatever you think your time is worth. So that's the two ways that I would monetize this. So now let's take a look at the prompt itself, which is probably what most of you are here for. And this will be in a doc in the description as well as in the first comment. So, you know, if you want to use it yourself, it's yours to use. So this is the prompt. This is one that, to be perfectly transparent, I found somewhere online. And I took and I changed it to be worded and work the way I would want it to work and the way I would phrase it and the way I would make a prompt like this. So that's what this is. This is the exact prompt that I used to generate the audits that we just saw and then the 120 some that I did over the last couple of days. And hopefully some of you are the same people that got some of those. But I'm just going to walk you through each line of it. Please help me optimize a business for local SEO. Maybe I'm the only person that says please to ChatGPT, but if it takes over the world someday, I'm going to hope that it remembers the people that were nice to it. Then please pretend to be a local SEO expert and give me all of the following requests, talking to me as if I am a child. I put it that way so it will use as little jargon and be as basic as possible. So first is to first make a list of the most important thing a business can do to optimize their local SEO. That's so it has one thing right at the start that people can do right off the bat, because most of us have attention spans that are about the size of a germ. So we have to have something right in the beginning that people can do, or they're not going to read the whole thing. Next, create a commerce separated list of the 10 best long tail search keywords this business should try to rank for to get local customers. That's pretty straightforward. It gives you 10 easy keywords, basically. Please mention these keywords should all be added to their Google business profile and website, and no keyword should only contain the name of a city. That one I found was necessary, because if you didn't, it would just put in like Milwaukee or Myrtle Beach or something like that. So that's just a quirk, I guess. Please capitalize the first letter of each word, you know. Next, please write a short business description. It's SEO optimized for this business. I think that's pretty straightforward. It helps you write the business description. I don't know about you, but I always struggle with that. And then suggest that this description get used as the website meta description. So basically, also as the meta description for the website, as well as for the GMB. So I've actually never tested that, but I wonder if that does make a difference. So we'll go ahead and assume that it does. Next, please write a longer business description that is SEO optimized for the business. Both descriptions should end with a call to action. That's just good writing. Then please provide a list of many services using SEO keywords that this type of business should add to their Google business profile that people in the area are likely searching for. Now, this one did give me some problems. It ended up on several businesses that I sent these to, listing services that they don't offer. You know, you want to make sure that it is something that business offers before you ship this over to someone, unless you're just going to go like, you know, maybe you should offer these things too. Maybe you never thought of that, but just be aware of that. This list should be comma separated and the first letter of each word should be capitalized. Pretty straightforward. Should be at least 10 services in the list. I found that was the number before it started getting a little silly. So there's that. Please put each of these answers in a nicely formatted table. I put that in sometimes it does it and sometimes it doesn't, along with an SEO optimized description for each of the services you came up with. So that was something that people really seemed to appreciate. Now, this one I had worded differently and it just made it not work as well. I had it say, this business is called, the name of this business is business name and it's located in location. And phrasing it that way made it not work as well. I don't know why. So I changed it back to the way it was when I found it, which is the business to help with me with is A, then business name, comma, location. And like I said earlier, you can change the location to just be the city. You can change it to be city and state. You can change it to be city and state spelled out, or you can change it to be city, state, and country. It didn't seem to make much difference. Now, out of the 100 and some of these I did, most of them came out great. There were a couple where the business name was ambiguous and it got it wrong. And like it didn't do it for like the right business or the right type of business. And it was because the name of the business was like, I forget the exact name, but there was at least three of these. But one of them was like, it was like clean me up or something like that. And it thought it was like a maid service, but it was for a crime scene cleanup service. So, you know, it didn't get the right types of services. It didn't get the right type of business. There was another one that was like a digital marketing agency. And it was, I don't want to give away the name, but it had a name that had to do with thoughts. So it thought it was a psychiatrist or something like that. So, you know, you do need to check the output. It's not 100% every time, but I think this is great output for a, this is pretty cool output and a pretty cool thing for an easy prompt to use. And I think if I were still trying to get at local SEO clients, I would absolutely be bombing out emails every single day, sending these to people that need local SEO. I would, you know, just go use a scraper, or I'd buy a service on Legiit to get a bunch of business lists, a list of bunch of businesses, and send it over to them. And then I would also list it on Legiit as something I can do for other people and sell it for $6 to $20 there, just depending on what you think you can get. So there will be a link in the description and in the first comment with a way to download the prompt so you can use it for yourself in whatever way you see fit, whether it's for your own businesses, whether it's to get clients, whether it's to help existing clients, whether it's to sell on Legiit, which is what I'm hoping for. It's there for you. So I'm probably going to put it behind some sort of thing where I collect your email because I'm a marketer and I just can't help myself. But, you know, either way, it's yours to enjoy. You can also just go copy it from the video if you want to do that too. So let me hop back fully on camera. All right, there you have it. That is the script that I modified and used to do over 100 ChatGPT local SEO audits in about a day or so. So like I say, it's not the most in-depth thing, but I think for something that you generate with a copy, a paste, and a click is pretty great. And it's a great way to start some conversation with some prospects or to make a little extra money on Legiit. So yeah, that's what I got for you today, guys. I hope you enjoyed that. I hope you'll use it. It's in the description. It's in the first comment. That's it. I might do more videos like this. Let me know if you'd like these, and I'll find more ways to make prompts that do stuff for you to help you with your business and your agency and whatever else you have. So check me out on legiit.com. Check out the dashboard on legiit.com. Check out the dashboard on legiit.com to optimize your whole business all in one shot and find the people that you need to get more stuff done. My name is Chris M. Walker. I'll see you again soon. Peace.